My first guests have been called one of the greatest Southern rock and roll bands, with hits like Sweet Home Alabama and Freebird. Lynyrd Skynyrd is still wildly popular today. They talk to me about their success, their tragedy, and the special role Atlanta plays in their musical legacy.
We are Lynyrd Skynyrd!
After more than four decades of making music, members of Lynyrd Skynyrd insist they are still just blue jean wearing, guitar playing, good old Southern boys out of Jacksonville, Florida, who love to rock and roll.
What was it like now? You were in Jacksonville. You were a baby.
Mm-hmm.
You were a baby. But why wasn't the music, you think, back then, when you all were doing the music, everybody was like, whoa, what is going on?
We grew up in a time period of the late 60s, you know, when it was really a rebellious thing. You know, music was rebellion anyway. Rock and roll was, you know. But we also, in Jacksonville, everybody always says, what was it about Jacksonville? And I think that it was just a different sound back then. It was, once again, it was blues-based, kind of a little bit country, but rock and roll. And all of a sudden, it had its own thing.
I'm the real Lynyrd Skynyrd.
The coach, the gym teacher this group was named for.
He was my gym coach. His name was Lynyrd Skynyrd. And when you took a shower after gym and stuff, your hair would kind of, it was back in the Beatle days, and you couldn't have hair to touch your eyebrows or over your ears. So we used to grow our hair long and comb it back with Vaseline. And during the school, but during gym, it would fall down, and he'd see us and kick us out and make us go get it cut. And you'd get suspended. And after so many times, he just finally kicked us out and said, don't come back. And so we named the band after him and changed the spelling so we wouldn't get sued.
Did he come to you all and say, what did he say? Because you know he knew.
He said, get a haircut.
Yeah, he just said, get it.
In Florida, the band won a contest. The prize, a recording deal here in Atlanta. The trip would put them on the road to superstardom.
We recorded here and made it out of the clubs here. Like I say, this is our home. When we first made it back in the 60s, we won a battle of the bands in Jacksonville, and our reward was to come up to Bill Lowry's studio and record a song with Joe South. That's when he was hot. And the things people do, you know.
Yeah. The older and games we people play.
Yeah, and we did a couple tunes with him, and that was a big thrill for us. We were just teenagers.
I'll tell you one thing that freaked me out in learning about you all. Sweet Home Alabama was done, recorded here in Atlanta.
Yeah, our first album was recorded here, and Streets of Ours, our very last half of it, was recorded here in Doraville.
You couldn't believe that people think we're from Alabama.
Yeah, people think you're from Alabama, and I go, no, they're from Jacksonville, Florida.
That sounds weird, though. Sweet Home Jacksonville.
Y'all know who run this here, baby.
When I Googled it, Sweet Home Alabama has been done by literally everybody.
Sweet Home Alabama, keep chrome in the seat, homie, watch your manners.
Even in Japanese and German.
Oh, yeah.
What is it about this song that is internationally accepted?
You know what?
Great
hook. It's magical. It's just magical. You have these songs that come along every so often, you know, that just has this magic about it.
Sweet Home Alabama.
Now, Billy, I'm thinking about coming to Atlanta, going to Finocchio's.
Oh. Yeah.
What was the city like back then?
It was crazy. I mean, it was wild. Golly Moses. I mean, it was just, we loved coming up here. And then, of course, it was Richards was where we got discovered by Al Cooper. But we just loved coming back and forth because that's where the big money was. You know, we could actually make $20 a piece. You know, that was big money.
Mm-hmm. Studio 54, Atlanta, there was places like that here where you'd all the bad things and drugs and alcohol and yeah. craziness went on here, and it didn't go on in Jacksonville. We made it. We'd come here to play the clubs because there weren't hardly any there, except for sailors, a lot of Navy bases for sailors, and exactly. they used to fight us because we had long hair.
No.
So we used to fight our way out of bars up here, and they liked it, so we just loved Atlanta.
ˌlɛnərd SKINNERD's first recording went gold, and so did their next three albums. In 1976 at the Fox Theater, the band recorded One More for the Road. That live album went platinum, and the boys presented a special album to then Mayor Maynard Jackson.
Don't forget, son, there is someone above.
Thursday, October 20th.
The success was bittersweet for the group. Weeks after their fifth studio album was released, their tour plane crashed. Six people were killed, including guitarist Steve Gaines, his sister Cassie, and founding member Ronnie Van Zant.
Sit beside me, my only son.
His brother wrote some incredible lyrics, and I've often said he was a poet way before his time,
yeah.
knew how to put it in words in terms that people on the street could really understand and get next to. And that was the real key secret. We sweated a lot together. We played a lot. We fought a lot. We ate a lot together. And you know what? We were living the times of our lives then, and we didn't even know it.
Three brothers, yeah, of course, Ronnie, yeah. Donnie, and myself. I think we're all different in many different ways, but I sure wish I had some of that songwriting talent, yeah. Eddie.
10 years after that crash, the surviving members regrouped. Ronnie Van Zant's younger brother, Johnny, joined the band. But in the years that followed, there was more tragedy for the group. Founding members Alan Collins and Leon Wilkeson died. Even with the setbacks, Lynyrd Skynyrd rolled on.
What's your name, little girl? What's your name?
The band's staying power was honored in 2006. They were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Lynyrd Skynyrd!
And just recently, they became members of Georgia's Music Hall of Fame.
We were flabbergasted and just freaked, you know. It's such an honor. We made it out of this town, and this is really home to us. So to be inducted in the Hall of Fame here is just such an honor, and it humbles us a lot.
But how much longer can y'all stay out on the road doing this?
Hey, you know what the Rolling Stones are doing as well into their 60s? You know what? Look at Keith Richards, man. I mean, he is like one of my heroes. And I mean, if he can do it, we can do it. That's it.
If I leave here tomorrow.
When we play some of these tunes, they'll cry or they'll sing with you and they'll laugh and they remember all the old days. And back in the day, you know, when they first heard it. And then their parents, some of the young ones, their parents played it, and they're hearing it or seeing it for the first time, and they finally are getting it.
Yeah, it really
and
is a new
such
generation.
A thrill. I hope we never quit, you know. I hope we do another interview with you in 20 years.